One of the really exciting things about the brand new Epson S9170, in addition to the 10 channels of amazing color, I have an 11th channel in here that I can utilize to print white ink. I'm going to go through the process of setting up white ink in my machine to show you what it looks like in real time. White ink is one of those things you don't want to leave inside your machine unless you're using it regularly. Epson actually recommends that if you're not going to use it within 2 weeks, you should go through this flushing process of removing your white ink and filling it up with a cleaning cartridge. I currently have a cleaning cartridge inside my machine, and I went ahead to Grimco.com and ordered myself a 1500 milliliter bag of the white ink. What's really neat here, another cool thing with the S9170 is I can choose whether I'm going to use the standard 800 milliliter cartridge or go with the bulk ink option of 1500 milliliters. I'm going to pay a little bit less for the gas for the 1500 milliliter versus the 800 milliliter, but ultimately if I'm not using it, all of these things do have an expiration date. So if it's in your machine, make sure you're using it. If you're going to use a lot of it, you can benefit from a little bit of ink savings by going with the 1500 milliliter. So all these parts are available at Grimco.com. You can check out the pricing. Make sure you do the math correctly. You're ordering the appropriate amount of size container. But ultimately, if you have your white ink inside your machine, you want to be printing with it regularly. To put a definition on that, I would say about 30 milliliters of ink deposited every 2 weeks for it to make sense. Generally speaking, the machine uses about 1 milliliter of ink per square foot. So think about that when you have your white ink in there. If you don't have a job in the pipeline that you're going to print in the next week or so, about 30 square feet of white ink, it may be beneficial for you to just go ahead and remove the white ink from the machine, put the cleaning cartridge. But definitely don't just leave it in there and ignore it. It'll let you know every day to shake the white ink cartridge when it's in there. But if you're never printing with your white ink, it's never moving the ink from the bag all the way up to the print head. So definitely take care of your machine and use that white ink when it's installed. Without any further ado, let's jump through the process of adding white ink to our machine. Okay, from the front panel, we're going to go to General Settings and then Printer Settings, and then we're going to scroll on down here, and then that's where we're going to have Change Color Mode. So I'll click on there now. It's lit up blue because I'm sitting in 10 color mode, but I want to switch to 11 color mode. This process I'm going through is the exact same if you have white ink in your machine to reverse out. There, my 11 color mode would be activated, indicated in blue, and I'd be switching back to 10 color mode. But let's go ahead and switch it up here. So at this point, it wants me to check to make sure I have a sufficient amount of ink to complete this process. So I'm going to remove the cleaning cartridge, which was an 800 milliliter bag, and I'm going to go ahead and place in my 1500 milliliter bag of white ink. You'll see here down below, it recommends shaking the white ink. We're going to hold it here, and we're just going to give it a nice agitation side to side. You don't want to create air bubbles. You definitely don't want to rupture the connection between the bag and the ink junction there. You're just agitating that ink. So we're doing a left to right motion for a count of 25 to agitate that ink that's inside the bag. This is the exact same motion you're going to do on a daily basis with this ink when it's installed in your machine to keep it fresh on a daily basis. And that's just keeping the ink resuspended, that crushed titanium dioxide pigment inside here, keeping that suspended inside the carrier fluid. And then we're going to go ahead and put this back inside our machine. Close the latch, hit OK here, and it's going to check to make sure I have a sufficient amount of fluid. All right, now what pops up on the screen, it's asking me to empty the waste ink tank. It uses a decent amount of fluid through this process, so it behooves me to go ahead and make sure I start with a empty waste ink tank. I'm going to go ahead and take my waste ink tank out and dispose of it in my disposal container. Now the next prompt on the screen where I have a red X for my maintenance cartridge, it's asking me to take out my ink bag that I had just placed in there, and I'm going to return the container completely empty, nothing inside there at all. Now at this point, the ink discharging is going to take place. There is an empty cartridge inside my machine. It's just draining the cleaning fluid that was in there previously. It's going to take about 5 minutes or so for this thing to go through its process, so I thought this would be a good time to share with you guys from Grimco.com the parts that I'm using here for the S9170. So you can see we got a 1500 milliliter or an 800 milliliter, and the cleaning solution only comes in an 800 milliliter, whereas my white ink, I have the option of going with the 800 milliliter or the 1500 milliliter. While we're here, I want to show a feature at Grimco.com that may be helpful for you guys. It certainly saves my life all the time here. I created a My Favorites list for every printer that I have, and for the S9170, I created a standard 800 milliliter cartridge list. So here are all my inks. Anytime I need to order the inks for this machine at 800 milliliter, I have the part numbers added. Simple matter of just grabbing the correct one, quantity, add it to my cart, and I'm ready to go. This also lists the maintenance kit that's available for the machine, the wiper unit, the fill plate, and then the aerosol containers as well. But then likewise, like I said, the bulk unit is on here also, separating the two. So this is the part number, the SKU for the 1500 milliliter. Really making ordering easy. I'm not having to search around and remember which ones are which. I have my white and my 1500 mil, all the other colors, and then my 800 milliliter cleaning solution too. So if you're doing this frequently, going back and forth, having your white, not having your white, you definitely have to have full containers or almost full of containers to go through this process. So make sure you have the ink on hand before you begin the process. Okay, it is finished draining the cleaning fluid. Now it's telling me to go ahead and place my white ink cartridge back inside the tray. So I'm gonna take that empty tray out, place in my 1500 milliliter ink bag. If you didn't shake your ink bag previously, now would be a great time to do it. Give it a nice agitation side to side. Again, don't create bubbles in there or break the junction between the plastic filler port and the cartridge. Set that in there, hit okay. And now ink charging is gonna start. And this process is gonna take about 14, 15 minutes to complete. So now on the screen, it's telling me that the process has been completed. We're all good, showing 11 color mode. I wanna finish this off by doing a nozzle check. So I'm gonna go back to my home screen, menu, maintenance, and then printhead nozzle check. So as you can see here, I now have a clean nozzle check. The white ink channels, there's two of them set up on here. It takes a little bit of playing with some light to see it when you print it on some white material. Maybe drop in some clear material or some off-colored white material to really make sure you have all those sufficient nozzles showing for your white channel. I hope you guys found this video helpful working through adding white ink to your printer. Go ahead and check out all the videos we have for the Epson S9170 on Grimco's equipment support page, as well as all the other equipment that Grimco sells, and let us know how we can help you grow your business. Thanks for watching.